Ah, I remember when this game came out in 2005. I saw it on the shelves and took it home straight away. I remember the guns and aiming being so cool and unlike anything I've seen before. The action was so over the top and awesome, and the dialogue was just over the top cheesy that made it so funny. That's how these videos normally start with this game, don't they? Well, I'm sorry to disappoint people, but that's not my experience despite holding a copy of the GameCube version. No, I saw this in a second-hand shop a few years ago. I bought it and, to be quite honest, I've never played it. I still haven't played this version, funny enough. I've always found it hard to get into the Resident Evil series. I tried Mercenaries on the 3DS, no fortune. I tried Revelations 1 on the Switch again, no opinion. I probably didn't pick the best games to start with, I won't lie. No, I started liking the series with the Resident Evil 2 remake, and ever since then I've been going through as many mainline Resident Evil games I can get my hands on. And Resident Evil 4 being the big boy of the series, and the series having its 25th anniversary as well, I thought it was the perfect time to play it. The hype around this game says you can't be a Resident Evil fan without kissing this game's arse on a daily basis. It's the game that most people think of when you say Resident Evil. So I played the PS4 version hoping to say the same thing as other people say as well, that it's one of the greatest games ever made. Resident Evil 4 fans, have you played this recently? I think you got your nostalgia goggles up a wee bit high there. Seriously though, if you're expecting another arse kissing about this game, go somewhere else. This is an honest review of the game, and it will consider its faults, its strengths, its age, and its impact. Right, let's start off with the gameplay. Resident Evil 4 was the first game in the mainline series to ditch the fixed camera angle and had gone for a third person over the shoulders camera angle you'll find in a lot of shooters, even to this day. Games like Last of Us and Gears of War come to mind in particular, but even then not all of them go into the detail that Resident Evil 4 does. When you shoot the enemies in certain places on their bodies, they will react to it. You shoot them in the knee, they fall onto it. You shoot them in the head, they move back gripping their forehead. When they're doing these types of animations, you could either keep shooting them, run away, or you could even do a kick that sends the enemy and nearby ones flying if you catch them in the kick, giving you some great crowd control moves. But unlike other third person shooters, the aiming has debatably aged. And yeah, I think it has personally. But, like say Metroid Prime, the game is built around this aiming style. When you aim, you cannot walk at all, you're standing still till you let the aiming button go. When you aim, instead of crosshairs, you get a laser sight that'll let you know what you're aiming at. And this laser is pretty good. I'd rather have the crosshairs, but it works for this game. This kind of setup still keeps the tension of the old games, as enemies don't hide behind cover and are constantly moving towards you. Enemies slowly moving close to you, and thanks to that locking movement, you've got to decide whether it's worth shooting them or running back. If some enemies come too close, that could mean instant death. Mixed aim with the limited ammo and the aiming style that takes a fair bit of effort to get used to, you still get that survival horror experience that the older games had. The problem is, compared to other Resident Evil games, this is the main thing you do. You just shoot people. I know a lot of other games you can say that about, but they normally have something else to crux that. The older and modern Resident Evil games normally have puzzles and exploration to split this up. Now, Resident Evil 4 does have puzzles, but they're either very annoying, such as the one that Ashley is forced to do, which belongs in a Professor Layton game, not a Resident Evil one. More on her later. But other than that, most puzzles are just fetching item A and B, sticking them together, and take them to spot C. Nothing to work out on how to get them, or any exploration is needed to find these items. You just fight dudes and get them. Another method is to put different types of enemies into the combat, and with this game being more action focused, it could work, but they really half-arsed it. Most of the enemies are just the same dudes with either a shield, a ranged weapon, or some kind of bug in his head. Now, I admit the bug guys add a little different. One has a ranged attack and the other can insta-kill you, but these can be resolved by keeping your distance, which you'll be doing with the other enemies anyway, making them not much different really. Now, some people will point out such enemies as the dogs or the chainsaw guys, but they happen so rarely it's kind of pointless to mention. I give credit that dogs are a bit different. You'll need to be fast with a shotgun to get them, but the chainsaw guys,
Just shoot them in the knee, kick them down and kill the others. It's not that hard. But they're still fun to fight, don't get me wrong. They still add tension. They're just barely there. There are some area exclusive monsters, such as the bugs in the sewers, that turn invisible. And I think spit acid? I can't quite remember, to be honest. And probably the scariest ones of all, the regenerators. They can take so much ammo to take down and can hit you so hard that you have to question whether it's worth fighting them or not. When you shoot their legs off and they jump at you, it is genuinely scary. But shooting them mid-jump is rather hilarious as well.
I know it's a tell an interesting story, but I'll talk about that in a bit. Resident Evil 4 starts off great in the village, but because this is the only real gameplay loop in the 12-hour game, it gets repetitive rather quickly.
Now, there are a few things it keeps from other Resident Evil games, such as the limited storage system and the ability to combine items. Yeah, if you never played Resident Evil 4 and saw the suitcase scene in the Resident Evil 8 trailers, this is where it comes from. This is probably one of my most favourite ideas from this game. See, most survival games, you get a limited item space and certain items take up certain space, more some than others. Well, Resident Evil 4 turned this into a gameplay idea. It turns your item management into a mini Tetris-like game. Instead of a set block, your items can be moved and turned around to fit into your item case, giving you the chance to try and create more room so you can gather more items. And I won't lie, this is pretty fun. Also, your most important keys and treasures don't add to this item case. It's just healing items, ammo and guns, which is a blessing for this game as you'll need every bullet you get. The game's graphics are also great in places. The environment textures are awful on HD screen. As I said before, I'm playing the PS4 version of the game, so it's in HD. You can definitely tell this is where the brown era of games began. But the models though, they are incredible. They look like they belong on an early Xbox 360 game, not the GameCube.
Okay, I think I've listed the main points of the gameplay. So, here's one thing that everyone agrees on, is that the dialogue is dead cheesy, silly and fun. A lot of people compare it to the Evil Dead series, you know, with Leon's one-liners and such being compared to Ash. Yeah, I massively disagree with this. I can't tell if it was the dialogue or the voice acting. I think it was the dialogue, but it's delivered in such an awkward way. It's not funny at all, it's just terrible. You tell me this.
La campana. Es hora de rezar. Tenemos que irnos. Sattler.
Where's everyone going? Bingo?
Is anywhere on the same level as this?
Sure, I could have stayed in the past. Could have even been king. But in my own way, I am king. Hail to the king, baby.
They're not on the same level at all. Most of the game is played like a horror-themed Metal Gear game, just not the stealth. Anyway, to the story.
Leon is sent into an unnamed European country.
It's Spain. The people talk Spanish, so it's Spain.
You see, the president's daughter, Ashley, has been kidnapped by a cult called the Los Luminados, and the American government has sent Leon Kennedy to get her back.
Okay, for one, the story is already buggered. If the president's daughter was kidnapped, the goddamn American military would be knocking down their door if the Spanish one hasn't already. Wars have been started over less, and trust me, Spain ain't winning that war.
Leon arrives at a village to find out he's been infected with a virus called Las Plagas. After a pretty decent opening shootout, Leon gets kidnapped and his coat gets nicked for some reason. During the kidnapping, Leon is infected with Las Plagas and meets Lucius Serra. I believe that's how you pronounce his name, I don't know. The two escape and go their separate ways. Leon then meets the merchant, a random infected who sells guns to Leon for some reason.
Okay, I like the idea of a shop in the game, but why is an infected selling this stuff?
Eventually, Leon reaches a church that Ashley is locked in, but he needs a key to unlock it. But to get the key, he needs to go across a lake, which causes him to fight Del Lago, a giant shark fish.
I wonder what virus caused that.
Leon beats the beast by throwing a load of hunting spears at it. This is probably one of the best boss fights in the game, it's just brilliant. Leon gets injured and has a fake out dream and then gets the key. On his way back he fights El Gante, a giant monster.
I wonder what virus caused that.
Eventually Leon gets to the church and saves Ashley. While escaping he meets Osman Sadler, the main villain of the game, and the man has no presence in this game other than here, a moment in the middle and at the end. He is the least rememberable villain in this game till the very last moment. Leon and Ashley escape to a house and meet up with Lucius once more, who does the creepiest pickup line I've ever heard.
I see that the president's equipped his daughter with ballistics too.
How rude! And I don't believe there's any relevance with my figure and my standing. Who are you?
Oh, excuse me, Your Highness. Perhaps the young lady might want to introduce herself first before asking someone his name.
Her name's Ashley Graham, the president's daughter.
Is she... well, you know.
Don't worry. She's...
Ew! He even turns around and makes Ashley apologize to him. I normally hate cancel culture, but goddamn if they want a target, here you go. I can't even call this a product of the era, as it would have been messed up even then. Who approved that line?
Now we are up to what is considered the most hyped up bit of the game. Everyone talks about it. The bit where Leon is surrounded in the house with a near infinite amount of enemies attacking them. And it doesn't do anything for me. I think back in the day it would have been cool, but it's been used so much these days it's lost on me sadly. Loads of action games have used it. Hell, stuff like Gears of War, Mass Effect 2 use waiting in a position and shooting enemies till they stop as the main form of combat. Don't get me wrong, if I was playing it at the time I might have found it cool, but it's overdone there. I'm not complaining Resident Evil 4 did it, it's more of a shame it didn't do anything for me sort of moment. After a few moments the infected get called away, Leon and Lucius separate again. You got two pathways now, one on the left or right, and each path has a different trap. Go with the left, you shoot guys and face two chainsaw guys. It's easy and fun. The right involves another giant monster who you have to outrun and find a key to unlock a door so you or Ashley don't die. It's complete bullshit.
Speaking of bullshit, it's time to talk about Ashley.
Ashley has a health bar that you heal with healing equipment. Why? This is the one thing I'm glad The Last of Us and God of War didn't rip off. So not only are the monsters trying to kidnap her, but they're also trying to kill her.
Sweet Lord, game. Pick one, not both.
Yeah, there are moments where you need Ashley to do a puzzle for you, and while she's doing that, people are trying to kidnap her. And if they take her, game over, dude. As soon as that's done, Leon fights Bitores Mendez in a rather grim boss fight. Leon kills him and takes his eye to access a castle. This is where the second half of the game starts and where Leon meets Ramon Salazar, a short Napoleon dressed man.
Why did they go with that? Napoleon was French. They probably wanted people to go, oh look at the weird short man. The guy is the most rememberable boss in the game, but I feel like it's more of a case of Stockholm Syndrome than anything. He's the character Leon interacts with the most. More than Ashley, more than Aiden, more than Sadler.
Ashley starts coughing up blood that shocks us to the point of running off and getting caught in a trap like a dumbass. Leon goes around the castle searching for Ashley only to bump into Ada.
Now I haven't played the original Resident Evil 2, but everyone said the remake was extremely faithful to the original. So I assume Ada would nearly die in that one as well. So I ask, why was their first interaction so cold? Leon finds out she was working with Wesker, but still no. How did you survive? It's so weird and not the direction I would have went with them. I know Ada has to keep her distance, but Leon doesn't.
Leon finds Ashley, who has not been collected by anyone despite how important she is to the cult's entire plan. Lucius returns and reveals he's been working for the cult on the virus and gets killed by Sadler.
Oh man, so sad. Creepy ass bastard.
So after neither Sadler nor Leon attempt to kill one another despite being in the same room in that scene, Leon frees Ashley by shooting the bars holding her to the wall. Yeah, that's a great idea. And then you start taking control of Ashley for a brief moment and you puzzle your way back to Leon for a little bit. I think in the Japanese version they even put in the old camera angles from the older games, which is cool. I don't know why they didn't do it in any other version. Eventually Leon and Ashley meets up only for her to get kidnapped by Salazar again, who tells Leon they're going to do the final ritual on her.
What's this ritual, you may ask? I don't know. The game doesn't care, because as soon as you get to Salazar, he tells you it's been done and Ashley is off to the cult military island. We don't even get to see it. So it's relevant, see? It's bugger all.
Salazar turns into a giant snot on the wall, which we have to kill in a rather bland boss fight. Then Ada gives Leon a lift to the island, and honestly, this is where the game gets too much for me.
I wish Salazar was the final boss slash main villain, as that would have been a perfect way to end the game. We save Ashley, the castle self-destructs, the end. But no, more plot points the game barely cares about needs finishing.
You go through the first part of the island with an attack helicopter for backup, which is cool. Then it gets shot down because it's a Resident Evil game. Eventually you fight Jack Crazer, who Leon is supposed to know from somewhere, but I barely care at this point. First it's in a shitty quick time event and then a shitty boss fight. After that you do another boss fight with what I looked up to be named It, which is a pretty cool boss fight, as the first stage is kind of an escape room type deal. Rather creative, I must admit. Leon breaks into Sadler's lab, rescues Ashley and removes the virus from both of them, but one issue. Sadler has got Ada now. So you go up to the final boss area where Sadler turns into a giant spider crab head thing and then you fight him. This is a rather cool moment, as I think it's one of my favourite boss fights in this game. It uses a lot of the elements of the basic combat really well. Eventually Ada gives you a rocket launcher to finish him off, and as you start to leave, the island starts to self-destruct.
Yeah, not the lab, the island. I wonder how much that cost to set up.
Ada reveals she's got a virus sample or something like that, and chucks Leon a key for a jet ski. Leon and Ashley escape in a pretty cool jet ski race against time into the ocean. Ashley hits on Leon, but he's not a creep, so he politely declines, and they both set off into the sunset. Apparently they were picked up by an American ship later on, but, you know, that's quite a lot of distance still. Anyway, the end.
The story is dumb. It's not cheesy or kind of like Evil Dead, it's just bad. This is a very story is here to give context for shooting people kind of story, but that doesn't mean it has to be bad. The Doom reboot had better storytelling, and its biggest joke was that nobody cared. But it was still a fun story. It was silly, but it was fun. I tried the other modes. There are a few Ada storylines. One is non-canon, so who cares? And the other one is just the game from her eyes. You find the guy who takes Leon's jacket if you care about that. But the big mode everyone knows is mercenary mode. A swarm survival mode, which I will admit is pretty fun. You kill enemies for points, and the more points you get, the higher rank you get. When you get to a certain rank on the different maps, you unlock new characters like Ada. I couldn't be arsed with it, to be honest. It's great if you're into the game. It really is. But I just didn't want to invest the time. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying not for me. You see, Resident Evil 4 is a weird game for me. It has a lot of good ideas and a lot of bad ideas. That is very typical of an ambitious game like this, and I will not deny that fact that Resident Evil 4 was extremely ambitious for its time, and a lot of the good ideas that succeeded in that game has influenced the industry for, well, till now really. No joke, as I said before, its influence can be seen in the God of War reboot. That's a 13 year difference. But a lot of bad stuff can be tracked to this game, like you know, quick time events and the Brown Age of gaming and stuff like that. But thinking about it, someone like The Evil Within ripped off Resident Evil 4 so much it's a borderline remake and people hated that game. Why? The Evil Within got similar ideas and some new ones and even refined some of the old ideas. It's got Shinji Mikami who made Resident Evil 4 on it, so what's the difference here? Mainly nostalgia, as I think that can be a big blinding factor to a lot of stuff that we won't admit. And the fact that Resident Evil 4's ideas were brand new at the time and weren't milked to death by the industry. Now, do I recommend Resident Evil 4? If you're interested in gaming history, it's as important as The Legend of Zelda or Super Mario Bros. To me. Does that make it a good game though? Kind of. It's not my cup of tea, but it's not bad. If someone asked me to recommend them a Resident Evil game, I would recommend the Resident Evil 2 remake. But if they liked it and asked me if Resident Evil 4 was worth a shot, I'd say yes, but keep your expectations in check. It is a 15-year-old game. And for all you big fans of the game, comment and tell me what you love about this game. I'd love to learn more. I've got friends who love this game to death. It's part of the childhood and everything. And I know they're going to skewer me like a shish kebab at the end of this review, but I kind of get why people like this game. I do. It's just not for me. But I have... This is just a random off comment. This is not really related to the review, but why are they remaking it? If the rumours are true, there might be a remake of Resident Evil 4 already deep in development. I think it might have hit a problem recently, but with games always do, it's just typical. But who would be satisfied with a remake? If it's a graphics polish, I personally won't care for it, and I don't know how the mainstream audience will be interested in it. Because if it's the exact same gameplay, the same stiffness, I think people will be put off by that. But if the gameplay is even remotely changed, the hardcore fans won't care for it either. It's kind of a lose-lose situation, in my opinion. I think if they were smart, they would go to change the gameplay and the graphics because the wider audience. That's just the market, that's just the business thing, in my opinion, but I don't know. I'd love to know what hardcore fans think about this remake. Either way, I hope Capcom don't screw it up, because they've been on quite a roll recently at the time of recording this video. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Like and subscribe for more content. I hope to see you again soon.